to do, ask them what they've done. And I also respectfully disagree. I think that actually there can and will be a hospital at the site of St. Vincent's. In fact, when the St. Vincent's Hospital, our only full-service hospital, was closed to build more luxury condominiums in this building, I stood up with the Coalition for a New Village Hospital and other organizations, and for 3 years fought and won an important victory, which was that we forced the Department of Health to admit that by law they are required to have a hospital at the site of St. Vincent's. Now then, nothing's ever perfect in these fights, so they turned around and said, fine, we have to give you a hospital. We're going to give you a 2.5-bed hospital. So, of course, the rhetorical question is, what in the world is a 2.5-bed hospital? I think it's a good start. And so what we next did was we had the hospital engineers come and evaluate the O'Toole building. The O'Toole building is the white building with the maritime circles on the west side of the building, the west side of the street, which is where the medical facility is going to be. And there's $139 million that's been set aside and earmarked for this healthcare facility. So we had AWU come, which is one of the premier hospital engineering firms, and analyze that building. And according to them, we could put 4 to 6 more floors on that building for the same or similar cost, and we could have a 200-bed hospital there. Now, that's a good start, wouldn't you say? So, as the next city council member, I'm going to continue the fight to take a 2.5-bed hospital and turn it into a 200-bed hospital, and I'm going to continue from there to make sure that we restore all that we lost at St. Vincent's. It was a level one trauma care center. It was responsible for, it had a pediatrics emergency unit. It was why we were able to have a midwifery and home births throughout most of the city. It was where the HIV/AIDS epidemic existed. Talk about wiping out an intricate web of important resources and knowledge. We need to start rebuilding that, and that's what I'll do as the next city council member, and I'll work closely with the community. We were able to organize over 8,000 community members. We worked with elected officials. We worked with over 50 different organizations, and I'll continue to build that kind of coalition as a city council member to get a full-service hospital back for our community. Thank you.
Thank you. The following question is for Yetta, followed by...